Cleveland Dental Hygiene Clinic is open to the public. For adults, it's $15, kids $10, and seniors. The services include x-ray, cleaning, and any necessary x-rays, and a fluoride treatment. These services are performed by our Lakeland Dental Hygiene students under the supervision of a licensed dentist. For more information or to book appointment today, call 440-525-7222. There are morning, afternoon, and evening appointments available in room each one, and check it out today.
And stolen by Mike Davis. Davis gives to Goodwin. Takes that. Puts up and in for two. Tip by Montel Goodwin. Gets the steal. Here's Mike Davis for three. No good. Rebounded by Wilson. Wilson puts back up and in.
Please come out and support Lakeland's women's basketball as they play Park State Community College on Saturday, January 20th. Information about Lakeland Athletics, please visit athletics.lakelandcc.edu. Go Lakers!
This is Mike Robbins.
It's a local music spotlight here on Lake Effect Radio. The Commonwealth Urban Soul.
Chad Show, episode 4, I think it is, of 2018, and I found something today that Larry Nassar, the USA doctor that sexually abused all those women, got 175 years in jail. I think that's good. Good that we did that. And, you know, if he wants to do something like that, you're going to have to pay the consequences, okay? The death penalty, I don't know if that's going to go into effect with him, but I don't think it should. I think he should suffer in jail, because, you know, all those women suffered from him. It's terrible. Terrible, terrible. But it's good that he's finally in jail and none of them... You know, they're all living through, like, PTSD or something, I guess. I don't know what disease I'd call it. But I'm sure if that happened to me, I'd be pretty sad and scared of a man doing something again. So, yeah, that's crazy. And we'll find some more news to talk about and my opinions on it. And, Filthy Frank, why is he a musician? Not saying he's bad, but he should stick to what he was doing before. Everybody loved him. Now he's like, oh, I'm serious. My name's Joji. Anyway, let's go to a song.
Couldn't hold me back. They're gonna rip it.
Wacky Chad Show back here. Tyler Vidmar is in the building.
What's up, my guys?
Haha, I don't know. So before he came in, I was talking about Filthy Frank, and I want to get your opinion on how he's a musician now. What do you think about that? You work with Trippie Redd. Do you see that music video?
No, I didn't see that.
Oh, yeah. It's with him and Rich Brian.
Okay.
And there's some other people. I don't know their names, but...
Rich Trigger, right?
Did yeah.
Did they release 18 or something like that?
I don't know.
I think they released that recently.
Oh.
On Instagram, on Susie Trash or whatever.
Yeah. Well, anyways, I don't like it because... I mean, he's a good musician. I'm not going to lie. Mm-hmm. But I want him to do Filthy Frank stuff, you know? I'm going to miss those barf cakes that he would make and stick it in Max Mofo's bunghole. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I miss him bathing
in a cup of ramen. Yeah, and How Too Basic. Well, he still does the stuff, but they're not going to do it together anymore. Sad, sad, sad. S-A-D, that's how you spell sad. Did you know that? Okay. I just wanted to ask you, because sometimes you spell happy H-P-P-A-V-I, wee-wee. You know? So, you got your spirits on you right now? You want to show them to the camera? It's right there. See that? It's yellow. How much did those cost you?
$7
and 80 cents. But hey, you're paying more for less harmful shoop. I meant to say the S word, but stopped it because you can't say that on the radio. And so we finished the album. Did you hear about that? Oh, it's all complete. It's all complete. Yeah, that. I remember that one song we recorded when you were there, and you threw up all the hot sauces. How was that experience?
That was a pretty bad experience. Cause, like, I had, like, a really nice, like, sub from, like, a sub shop. It's a Tommy's sub.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was delicious from like, second time. It's also worse on top of it. Like, I got the heat back from the hot sauces again.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Wow. So... Yeah, it takes a while for them to go away.
Yeah.
It took, which ones did you eat?
I tried all the Jack Adder experience, from like Nala to the last day.
Okay, so I got him that hot sauce, and we did a video on it, and I was okay on it, but you did a lot of other hot sauces, like you did Ultra Death too, right? So that one gets me more than Last Dab, but it's less Scoville, it's 1.2 million less. Which is a lot. And yeah, so you were... What color was it?
What
yeah.
Oh, it was like a nice
colors, like okay. Let's gross out people in the lunchroom right now.
Oh,
hey, we threw up pickles and orange stuff. All mixed together.
In a
bathtub. Yeah, in a bathtub.
Jack Grady's
bathtub, who used to be on the show, but he's at Ohio Media School. Doing radio. Well, he's not doing radio, but he's doing video stuff. Here, chew that closer to the mic. Oh, yeah. There you go. All right, we're going to play a song, and then we're going to get back. wait, shit, your mic wasn't up. Your mic wasn't on the whole time.
Oh, boy.
So we have Tyler in the room. He gave his opinion on Filthy Frank. That doesn't matter anymore, though.
Yep.
He showed me feedback, a friend of his that makes beats, and we're going to try and rap over it. Well, do you want to rap?
I don't know if I can rap clean.
Like clean word-wise?
Yeah,
or?
No, not I can't rap clean or whatever.
Okay.
I gotta have a free flow, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I mean, it's hard to, because mm-hmm. you'd be like, I don't want to say it. So maybe we should even do it. That's not a good idea.
I mean, we can
idea.
Just go and try and like give a little sample listen for the
all
people,
right.
You know?
Here, let's do the 1 minute one.
Yeah.
So that, you know, we can play it.
You're just now explaining the controls?
But, no, the shop's a great place.
The shop is a great place. And mm-hmm. do you know when the next time they're going to
I don't know. Usually, I remember I was talking to Steve-O, the, like, owner of the place or something, caretaker, I don't know, whatever.
His name's Steve-O, too?
Yeah.
Not the Steve-O?
Not the Steve-O.
That'd be cool.
That would be cool if Steve-O was from Jackass, was running the place or whatever, yeah. But it's not him. But yeah, no, like, I remember he told me they're on Facebook, the shop or whatever, it should be, like, the first thing you go on, like, comes up, and, he said that they try to do stuff every 3 weeks, but I don't know if
that's what I heard,
but I don't know if they really can, because they always smash their instruments at the end of every show.
Oh, they do?
I didn't get
to see the ending, but, yeah.
You missed a really good ending. Like, when I went there... We were there probably, we got there around like 9:30, just before it started taking off. There was a pretty good kind of like metal screamo band that was up there. They had like a nice front man or whatever. I remember he had like, what the heck is it? It's from Star Wars, the Maladroids tattoo or whatever mm-hmm. it was. on his arm. And then there's also, like, there's this pianist or, like, keyboardist, whatever you want to say, synth thing that he had. And he was just, like, total, like, glam rock and everything or whatever up there. They were pretty good. And then the owner of the place got up there. And he was like, yo, somebody go and bring me a cinder block in or whatever. And they, like, had that on stage. And then, like, I'm like, oh, these guys are pretty good. There's a lot of shouting or whatever. Some yeah. nice, like, hooky riffs and everything. Really, really kind of like a nice indie sound. And I was smoking a cig, sitting on one of the couches next to the door or whatever. Like, I'm like,
yeah.
I'm like, right here.
I know
here's
couch.
The door.
Yeah.
And I just see this plume of flame rise up from the crowd or whatever. The dude's setting his bass on fire.
Really?
And ends up stomping it out and then jumps down, picks it up, throws it in the middle of the pit and just smashes the thing. Like, wow. Just once after this set's over. And then, like, somebody from the crowd went up, grabbed the bass drum and threw that down and threw the cinder. Or no, Cameron actually kicked in the bass drum or whatever.
Cameron did.
Yeah. They're also setting off those, like, Chinese firecrackers or whatever, like the really big ones that look
yeah.
like ammo belts or whatever the whole time. I tried to open the door to kind of, like, let it fumigate, but, like, it was bad. It just smelled like sulfur and everything.
Yeah, when you go in there, you're going to have to wash your clothes 3 times to get them back to normal. Everybody was smoking cigarettes there.
Oh, yeah.
And other stuff.
And other stuff.
And other stuff. But we can't talk about that.
Yeah, what happens at the stop stays at the shop.
Yeah. And Cameron also... had a Roman candle and hit my leg. That kind of hurt a little bit. He was all the way across from the other side, and I was staying over there minding my own business, and all I feel is feels like a, not a gunshot, but it's something.
Like just like a nice hot poker or whatever?
Yeah, like if I got branded for half a second.
Wait, did it just like go and like graze you or whatever?
Oh, it hit me. And
oh,
like,
okay.
Right here.
Oh, shit.
But they're nice people there, everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, they're definitely nice people there or whatever. I want to go and make some slaps or whatever and go and start, like, for, like, some of the different bands that I know or whatever, start going and try and promote them. I know my buddy Nathan Dracago. I don't know if anybody knows him.
Oh, yeah, improv man.
Yeah.
I remember
big,
him.
Big, lanky, slender improv man with
yeah.
the He'd Justin
always go
Bieber
like,
haircut. Exactly.
At one time.
And but yeah, no, he Nathan Chicago's Surf Deer, I believe
that's still going.
Yeah, they're doing something. I think February 10th. I don't know. Look up more on Twitter. It's Surf Deer, I believe. And then I know Eric and Silas are having a February 2nd. They're gonna have some type of banger or whatever going on. That's gonna be at their friend Kelsey's out in like Willoughby or something like that.
Okay, go check them out, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Eric and Silas, sounds like an old Adult Swim show. And Surf Deer is an indie band.
Mm-hmm. Indie garage band.
Yeah.
Because they literally just play in garages.
And yacht clubs.
Or your parents' basement.
Yeah. Same thing. All of it's the same. You have the same audience.
But no, the very last band was called Fresh Bucket. And they were like, they got this like super groovy. They're on SoundCloud or whatever. You can look them up if we have to take another break or whatever and play that song. They're pretty good.
Yeah.
I like them.
I wanted to perform at the shop.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that'd be fun. We can do our screamo raps. Like, I know Jack does a lot more than I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Screams all the time. I mean, it's funny, though.
I'm surprised he hasn't damaged his vocal cords by now.
Oh, he has. I think he had to go to the hospital because he damaged his vocal cords.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't that when he was, like, spitting up blood or whatever?
Yeah.
And almost, like, choked death
yeah.
on his blood?
Yeah. He pays for what he screams. So talk about something while I find a juwapery.
Juwapery?
Yeah.
Juwapery. What is a juwapery?
Hey, you
is
know.
It the jewel of all the Burger King Whoppers? It's one of the most perfect Whoppers ever made.
Speaking of fast food, Taco Bell, French
T-Bell?
Fries.
T-Bell's got the French fries now?
Yeah, I think they're getting them tomorrow.
Oh, boy.
Go check those out, because they're going to be called, like, Mexican fries or something. I'm excited.
Mexi fries?
Yeah. Maxi pad fries. Oh, God.
But here, look up on SoundCloud if you can play that through or whatever. Fresh
is
Bucket.
Does it swear?
No, I don't believe so.
What's it called again?
Fresh Bucket.
Fresh. Is that one word or two words?
It's two words. but you know, they got a nice groovy sound.
At least they showed up.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's see.
Strainer, I'll Eat Your Soul, Final Start, Don't Stop, 44 Nuts. Where was Strainer. I yesterday?
Strainer's a good one.
Have $42 to your name, and I have $4 to my name.
Oh boy!
So a total of $46. What could we get? Share a dinner at Applebee's, or
maybe?
Well, Applebee's is actually pretty cheap. 20. Yeah.
And so. Also, I think they have like endless appetizers now too.
Yeah, so you can get a lot of food there. Even let's go to Applebee's.
Let's go to Applebee's. I remember. I think it was Cameron that showed me. There was some dude that was like just really like racist against Mexicans for some reason, and like they're like, all right, here, try this T-Bell taco, and he was like Taco Bell. I thought those were just Mexican churches, and he's like this is from Taco Bell. I thought this was from like a 5-star restaurant like Applebee's.
He must have really liked it, huh?
Yeah, he did.
Well, Taco Bell's good.
Oh yeah, T-Bell is where it's at, my guy.
What's your favorite fast food restaurant?
I'd have to say T-Bell, and then maybe a little bit like classier than T-Bell. I don't know. I just had Wingstop last night. That was really good.
Is that fast food or?
Yeah, it's fast food. Wingstop.
Kind of like pizza fast food. You know what I'm saying? Like you gotta order it and wait, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, it's like if you go to a Marco's or something. But Little Caesars, I think, is fast food because it's fast.
Yeah.
Marco's, they're like 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But it's worth it.
Yeah.
Got good. I like all pizza, really. Like, I haven't really had bad pizza.
Yeah, no. I mean, what is it? Like, pizza's, like is a good analogy to sex or whatever. Like, even when it's bad, like, it's still good.
Yeah, it's still good.
You know?
Yeah. Because, you know, hey, I'll take it.
Yeah.
If someone offered me, like, I don't know, God, what is there, broccoli or something, I'd be like, you know what, I don't really have to eat that.
Yeah, no, I
don't. But if I'm forced to, I guess, you know, I'm going to have to, but I don't want to.
Yeah, no, broccoli ain't good. Mm-hmm. I don't care for no broccoli. My mom told me, it's like, oh, it's just like you're eating little trees, and then you go and put the cheese on it, and it's all good, and I'm like, no, it still makes me want to throw up, Ma.
It's bad. It smells, too.
Yeah.
It smells like farts.
It really does.
Yeah, but the only time I'll eat it is if it's, like, in a stir-fry or something, mm-hmm. or at, like, an Asian place mm-hmm. where they have
some
fried
nice
rice.
Mongolian barbecue or something.
Yeah, because then it's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Not gonna lie. Every vegetable is.
There's just something that they go and do there or whatever. It's ancient secret.
Yeah.
Ancient secret.
Okay. They wouldn't be at this school. They're at Harvard. They're like, oh, God. All right. I did not say any of that.
Jeremy's going to come in here and take us off the radio, dude.
Yeah. Anyways. Cleveland Metro Park Zoo.
Dude, they got the hippopotamuses there. Hippopotamus.
Oh, no, that's at the Cincinnati one.
No, they got hippos there.
They do?
They're with the elephant exhibit, I remember.
Really?
I mean, I haven't been to the zoo in a while.
I haven't seen a hippo there since I was a kid, but ever since then, I haven't seen a hippo.
Maybe they got rid of them when they expanded the elephant enclosure. I'm not too sure.
Still good animals there.
Yeah.
I feel bad when I go there, though, you know. Just,
why?
You know, they're in captivity and they want to get out.
Well, I mean, I think they got a pretty swell job, though. I mean, they just get to sit there, you know, eat food and exist.
And they get to live longer.
Yeah.
But
like if like say an elephant was out in the Sarin, New Delhi or whatever it is, it would get eaten by a wild lion
but
or
also
a hyena.
That's saying that if we were put into cages and we had nothing to do.
Yeah.
Would you like to do that and live longer?
I mean, yeah. That's my dad always had the saying, three hots and a cot if you go to jail, baby.
Oh, man. So you would take the zoo if you were offered it?
Yeah.
Did you like to? What would you do to perform for people?
I don't know. I might do maybe like a nice like comedy act or whatever, and then people just throw stuff at me. Yeah. It's probably going to be terrible. If I don't go and figure it out, maybe I'll just going to like spend my time reading there or whatever and try and better myself, maybe. I don't know.
Be a learning experience.
Oh, yeah.
And there's also a Pizza Hut and McDonald's there.
Yep.
So you can always leave the exhibit and go. And they wouldn't be stopping you because you're a human.
Yeah.
And then, but you won't have any money, though. That's the problem.
Oh, I mean, I'd just go work back there or whatever, like, to pay it off, you know?
Yeah. Well, because you're working for the zoo.
Yeah.
So I'm sure you'd probably be getting it for free.
Yeah. I'll just be like one of the seagulls or whatever. I'll start making the seagull sounds, even though they have signs that say don't feed the seagulls.
Yeah, I hate like, those seagulls there.
The seagulls are
and bird. They have other birds
they're,
there.
They're rat
are,
birds, dude.
Yeah. Well, would you ever eat a seagull?
Possibly.
I'd have to see what the insides.
In a life or death situation, I mean, it's probably like the same with all birds. I mean,
chicken.
Yeah.
Probably tastes a little. It probably doesn't taste like chicken.
Probably a little gamey, because I mean they're just kind of garbage birds, really.
Yeah.
You just eat garbage all day.
So
like I remember I saw one just like eat an entire hot dog or whatever, just like shove it just all the way down, like a deep.
They're crazy.
That thing. They
I
are.
Think soon enough, like in 100,000 years, they're gonna become like the biggest birds of all time.
They're are gonna, they gonna be like be bigger than I forget. There was like it's like it was like one of the biggest like type of aerial creatures back in like the dinosaur days. It's even bigger. It's like a petrodactyl or whatever. It might have even been bigger than that. I can't remember.
Pterodactyl?
It's not a pterodactyl.
Oh.
It's like a petrodactyl or something like that. You could probably like Google it or something.
Well, it would definitely be bigger.
Don't fact check me.
Well, we're going to look it up right now. I'm going to see if I can spell it right. Petra. Boom.
One of the biggest like aerial creatures.
Well, I think these are pterodactyls. Oh shoot! That looks kind of scary. If that was like,
it's an origami boy.
No, but it would be it'd be a lot bigger.
You know, it was like
it'd be like a skyscraper size.
Yeah, like we were like maybe as big as his toenail.
Oh. Do you see the future? Cool. Yeah, I think seagulls are going to evolve into that.
And become bigger than anything.
Is that Sean Spicer?
No, I don't know. I don't know who that is.
You don't know who Sean Spicer is?
Nope.
The person who used to be the speaker for the White House.
No, I hate politics.
Oh, well, that's him.
Huh.
Oh, but yeah, seagulls, they're going to become they're going to start speaking English, and they're going to be reading books, and they're going to be little seagulls.
Are we going to have, like, bird people, like in Zelda?
Oh, yeah, we're going to be reproducing with birds, and we're going to look really weird. There's going to be humans with wings, which I think would be pretty cool.
Are they going to be, like, arm wings, or are they going to be, like, back wings?
Going to be arm wings.
Arm wings? Oh, yeah. That's going to be real weird.
Yeah, so then you got to put into effect other diseases that will be with that.
A new human avian bird flu thing?
Yeah, and it's very much worse than Ebola.
Oh. Oh, geez.
Yeah. And what other animals would evolve? Monkeys.
Mm-hmm.
They're still doing it.
Yeah.
I mean, every animal is, but
mm-hmm.
Those are pretty crazy.
Yeah.
But that's crazy how we came all the way from back then,
mm-hmm.
and now we're standing, talking, doing all this bullcrap mm-hmm. that we don't need to do. Like, hey, look at this picture on Instagram. I liked it. While there's other animals out there like, you know?
Yeah.
And they're just eating celery like, having a fun time, and we have to suffer with stress and love and that kind of stuff.
School.
Animals don't need to go to school.
No. Why would they need to go to school?
They don't need to learn.
I mean,
anything.
The only school they really go to is when a bunch of professor guys want to go and do some lab things.
Yeah.
On them.
And they come back injured and.
Yeah, and then they're just like
sometimes dead.
What the heck, dude? Why
would
you
do
that
to me, dude? I'm just a freaking mouse.
Yeah, mouse rat, dude.
Dude, I didn't deserve this. I was just in the sewer and you guys caught me. Like, dude, get out of here, man.
Dude. I was just trying to chill with a bunch of turtles named after a bunch of famous artists.
And now you just did this to me, dude. You cut me open. Like, what do you need this for?
Yeah, what do you need this for?
Oh, cosmetics, dude.
Oh.
So we're going to play another song.
Let's see if there's another banger beat from Brian.
Oh, yes.
It's a nice mystery box over here. Static.
That one.
What if it was just all static? Just like TV
stuff. We could find out. This one's pretty long.
Got spoiled.
Your milk got spoiled.
Yeah, milk got spoiled, and they're like, "Hey, man, this is pretty good. Let's turn this into something. Let's what do you want to call it? Cheese? All right,
that sounds pretty good.
Yeah,
yeah. We were just talking about how weird things, like normal things, came to be.
Yeah,
like what else is there that came to be?
Let's see. Maybe there was some guy like ice cream or whatever. He went and left it. Like, left his milk out in
the freezer.
Well, they didn't have freezers.
Well, back. Yeah.
Like, it was, like, wintertime or something like that. And, like, maybe he was trying to make, like, something else. And he's like, "Oh, man, all my milk is frozen now. What'll make this better? Let's go and put some sugar in it. Maybe some heavy cream or whatever. Or whatever it may have been. Maybe put some chocolate in there. Now we got Oreo cookies and cream."
Hey.
Would you look at that?
Yeah, would you look at that?
I know. I think it's like potato chips. There was some random dude that was like, "Hey, I don't want no french fries or whatever." He was like, "Order them at a diner or something like that."
Yeah. He's
like, "I don't want no french fries. I want the potatoes to be sliced as thin as possible and lightly salted afterwards, and like deep fried. And
that's what he requested.
Yeah, and that's how potato chips came to be.
So that must have not been that long ago.
Yeah, no, it was. Yeah, I don't know. And
that's crazy.
And then back in the day, they didn't even have sliced bread, dude. You had to slice it yourselves.
Yeah.
We have a lot of convenience nowadays.
Yeah.
Because, like, that's where the saying came from. It's even better than, like, before sliced bread. They just actually, like, back in the day, when, like, you had to make a sandwich, you had to eat two whole loaves of bread.
Really?
Yeah, because they didn't have sliced bread.
That
you know?
Is not good for you. No. Especially white bread.
Yeah. I don't know what's wrong with white bread. I really prefer white bread.
No, I like white bread. I'm just saying, like, it's not good for you.
I don't know why it's not good for me. I love white bread. Put that on PB&J. Heck yes.
So good. I'll take any bread, really, but there's some breads you can't have with certain foods, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I had to force to eat peanut butter and jelly on rye bread.
Oh, yeah, no, that's not a good
combination. It was okay, but it wasn't like, I don't want to eat it again.
Yeah, no, that I don't think that would be a good combination. I remember I actually tried, I forget what I was eating, but I remember I made like a sausage sandwich or whatever with like nice American cheese or cheddar cheese on it or something, and I put peanut butter on it or something like that, or like accidentally got peanut butter on it, and I was like, this ain't bad.
Because
that's how they go. Have you ever heard of the Goober Burger?
No.
It's just like a regular cheeseburger or whatever, but you put peanut butter on it, and it's supposed to be like heavenly.
Really?
Yeah.
Like peanut butter.
Yeah, they even have like, I remember, they even have like, I think it's some place up in like New York or whatever, you know, you got all the fancy restaurants up there.
Yeah.
They went and like showed them that, I don't know what I was watching, Tasty or whatever, BuzzFeed, whatever it may have been on the YouTubes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can't listen to BuzzFeed, though.
Why?
Trash. It's trash.
BuzzFeed is trash?
Yeah. That's what I've been hearing, and from looking at it, they're kind of stupid stories, but some of them are okay.
I really like watching, I think it was like 3 a.m. and I was going down the YouTube rabbit hole, you know, where you just keep clicking on the recommended videos.
Do that every day. Every day.
Or you just keep clicking on the recommended videos, and I ended up it was like Irish people going to try American snacks, and like they got to like ranch flavored, and they're like, why isn't this just American flavored? Like, I don't know why. It's like, we call it ranch, dude. I don't know.
Hmm.
And it was just like really weird. I think they were tasting Mountain Dew as well, and like they're like, this is all some type of divergent of lemonade, basically.
Yeah.
They really didn't like it for some odd reason. But Mountain Dew is the best dew.
It is pretty good.
Dew the dew.
Yeah. So, is Mountain Dew your favorite pop?
I would say so.
My favorite pop has to be Dr. Pepper or Sprite.
Dr. Pepper's good. Oh, speaking of Dr. Pepper, have you gone to Sheetz in a while?
No, but I've never gone. Wait, yeah, but I've never gotten Dr. Pepper there.
Well, no, but they have this Dr. Pepper, like, barbecue sauce. And it's one of the most amazing sauces.
Oh, I'm going to have to try that.
Oh, yeah. Just get a bucket of tater tots and get, like, 30 of those sauces. That's one of my top 5 sauces. And then, like, my number one sauce would be the zesty sauce from Burger King.
Is that...
It's like their onion sauce or whatever.
Oh, okay.
It's like a mayonnaise-based sauce with, like, kind of like a horseradishy flavor to it.
See, I work at Wendy's, so we have this sauce called Awesome Sauce.
Uh-huh. Is that just ketchup and mayonnaise?
No, it's eggs and like, I don't know what else is in it, but I can't describe it, but it's delicious. You gotta try it. If you get chicken tenders, get chicken tenders and Sossum sauce with it.
Sossum sauce?
Yeah, you'll be amazed.
Oh boy.
You'll be amazed by that Sossum sauce. It's crazy. And they have ranch there too.
Mm-hmm.
And barbecue, typical.
Yeah. What I really else? Like their the little chili, like the hot flavor packets or whatever they are.
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know what that stuff is, but it's good.
Yeah, a lot of people order it. Mm-hmm. I haven't had it, but I'm going to have to try it because I love hot sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you might love hot sauce after that night.
No, I still love hot sauce.
Okay, that's good.
It was one heck of a hot sauce high that I had like maybe a good 5 minutes after that.
Yeah.
I didn't like...
Dude, who needs heroin?
But no, I remember I was watching something. I was like, that's what, like, it's actually, like, addicts actually use that because, like, it goes and releases endorphins or whatever.
Yeah.
And, like, they go and use that to kind of try and, like, wean themselves off the juice or whatever it may be.
It could probably make you sober.
Yeah.
Because it's very, I don't know how to describe hot sauce, but it's something.
It's enlightening, my dude.
Take
a ride on a Tabasco train.
I put Tabasco sauce on my ice cream one time.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty good. Yeah. It tastes like strawberry.
Yeah, even, like, I remember they had that or whatever. I tried that one time. I had, like, vanilla ice cream, and we had this, like, I don't know, I think it was, like, Tastefully Simple my mom bought, but it was, like, a raspberry, like, type of hot sauce, and I put it on my ice cream, and that was good.
Yeah, so try it, guys. Put hot sauce on whatever you have, even ice cream, even in your water. Put it in your water.
Mm.
I don't know about that, but spice I'd probably still water. Drink it. Yeah, it's probably good for you.
Yeah.
Maybe not Tabasco stuff. Because, you know, sodium and all that stuff, but there's some, yeah, peppers you can put in it.
Yeah.
And it would be really good. I don't know how that's going to taste either, but
mm.
it's better. And it'll be spicy if you like spicy things and you're eating a spicy food and you're, like, looking around for a water and you have a pepper water, you're like, ah, it makes it even worse. Or you can put the last dab in the water, it up and see how that tastes. It tastes pretty good, though.
Yeah.
Like, there's some hot sauces that are just, like, hot and there's no flavors with it, but there's other sauces that taste good,
mm-hmm.
but are still hot.
Yeah.
Like, Last Dab, Ultra Death, I think is just hot,
mm-hmm.
in my opinion. And
yeah, there's no flavor to Ultra Death.
Yeah.
It's probably, like, what you would taste if you were dying.
Yeah. Because ultra-ly dying.
Yeah.
But they have, the people made that have this other, they have these other hot things. They're like crystals, I think.
Hot crystals?
And you have to burn it for it to be, like, edible and stuff.
And oh, they could. That's what they probably go and use in, like, the fancy schmancy, like, smoker things or something like that. Like, they go and have, like, it's like this machine or whatever. Basically looks like a bowl. And, like, it like, goes and takes all the smoke or whatever, and, like, you light it. And, like, you have, like, you're supposed to saran wrap it, and it has this hose that goes into there. And, like, it puts everything in smoke. They usually use that for, like, fish or whatever. Whenever you hear, like, smoked salmon or whatever.
Oh, okay.
They usually put, like, wood chips in it or something like that or
yeah.
whatever.
Yeah. But, yeah. So, there's a video of this person heating it up on a spoon and eating it from the spoon. And the spoon's already hot.
Yeah.
So, you can imagine how, like, I don't know how many, it's like a couple million Scovilles, like 10 million, 16 million. It's pretty high.
Oh, boy.
I would not want to do that.
He's got fourth degree burns, dude. There yeah. ain't nothing less than his tongue.
Yeah, and he felt like he was dying. And then I saw this funny video of this guy who's vaping Carolina Reaper.
Oh, no.
Oh, but he was dying. It was so funny, though.
Because I've seen, like, one where there was this guy, he put a Carolina Reaper pepper in his bong and, like, smoked it and, like, immediately just put down
God.
The bong and just started chugging water. Like, he probably severely damaged his lungs.
Maybe.
I don't know, but...
He could have, because I think that's a man-made pepper plant.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
I want to try one of the chips or whatever that they have. They like usually they're just individually packaged.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to try a full pepper. I know I would die,
mm-hmm.
but if I can get on video, be yeah. good views.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Because whenever, you know, you search up Carolina Reaper pepper... And all the views are at least a couple thousand.
Yeah.
There's never one like, oh, 20 views.
Yeah.
So get my name out there. Or you can record a song on Carolina Reaper. I know that there's
that
a...
That would definitely be something.
There's a video where these people all ate peppers and started doing a music, like a choir thing. It was funny. I think it was Carolina Reapers, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right, so you got 5 minutes, and then we'll be back at 4 o'clock. I don't know if you're going to be back, though.
Yeah, I don't know. Well, I mean, I don't have class today or whatever. I dropped 2 of my classes, so I don't have
anything. Oh, that's good.
Today.
And bad.
Yeah.
But you have Wingstop at home.
Yeah.
So that's like a class, basically. You're mm-hmm. learning how good Wingstop is.
Yeah. I already know that it's good, and I'm going to hope.
But you're learning
it
more.
Better.
It's like an advanced Wingstop class. It's like AP Wingstop.
AP Wingstop.
That's what you're taking.
Wait, this is the not the intro class. This is Wingstop 1800.
Or yeah, you're way up there.
Yeah.
Like, you're probably going to graduate pretty soon from Wingstop class. we've been playing Feedback, Fresh Bucket,
mm-hmm.
and other songs, MGMT, and the first song that we played, I forgot what it was.
Let's see, what's a song that I can think of that's a good, clean song?
You gotta give me a weird song to play.
A weird song?
Yeah.
You could try Boogie by Brockhampton.
Yeah, we're not playing rap on here, because I'm sure that's swears in it.
Really?
Because the only rap I play on here are clean hit ones.
I mean, you could probably look as if there's a clean version or whatever.
He's not that popular, though, is he, though?
Like, no.
So I don't think there would be. Because there's some songs that are really popular that don't even have clean versions.
We could play Stitches.
Stitches. What's that?
Stitches, he's like, just Google him or whatever and just look up his face, basically. It's pretty funny.
Okay, I'm scared.
Rapper or whatever.
Stitches,
I put,
rapper. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. Okay. Is he white?
Oh, yeah. It's like a really, like, screwed up version of Post Malone, I'd say.
He has a little bit of Machine Gun Kelly in him.
Something.
I don't know. His nose is fatter than his, but it kind of looks like that. Of course. They always got hand tattoos.
They always have hand and face tattoos. That's
if you want to become a rapper, you got to do that.
You got to have face and hand tats.
Yeah. Should I play that?
I guess.
All right.
Stevia! Got Stevia! Got